Welcome back, my fellow Earth economists. In this video, we are going to look at the full interaction between consumption, saving, and investment. At the end of the video, you will have built a model of the Earth economy, filled that model with real Earth data, and used it to analyze the Great Recession. I think you will agree that this achievement is pretty cool. The new component today is investment. A rise in investment implies that GDP increases. Decrease investment and GDP decreases. Therefore, the arrow carries a plus. Now, larger GDP means that consumption increases. And finally, we have the multiplier, the feedback loop from consumption to GDP. Now, let's take a look at how we can transform the flowchart into a model. Remember the three M's: math, manner, and meaning. We start with the definition equation that describes that production Q consists of consumption C and investment I. The next equation uses the definition that production equals income. Production generates income. Income generates production. The next equation is the investment equation. It is the simplest behavior equation possible. Investment is exogenous. That means it is given and not explained by our theory at this stage. It is constant and not influenced by the level of income. Now, perhaps you think that the unchanged level of investment is no behavior at all. But then you confuse behavior and activity. Finally, we have the consumption equation. Most macroeconomists would stop at this moment and start to solve the model. Mathematically, this can be done, but we are missing a very important part. We have behavior and definitions, but not yet an equilibrium equation. So, what would constitute an equilibrium? When would plans or desires become reality?
If firms invest what they want to invest, then they can be considered being in equilibrium. However, consumers may not fulfill their plans. So, no equilibrium. Alternatively, consumers could be in equilibrium while firms could see their inventories change, and firms would not be in equilibrium. This is why we need to formulate the equilibrium for the Earth economy in such a way as to clarify that the plans of both firms and households coincide. Now the plans in all sectors are realized and there is no force for change.
In order to solve the model, we need a saving equation. That is easy because we know that saving equals income minus consumption in our model. Now let us turn to the graphical analysis. As before, we have income Y on the horizontal axis, and on the vertical axis we have investment and saving. The brown saving function slopes upward. If income increases, people tend to save more. At zero income, people will dissave in order to pay for necessities. The green horizontal function represents investment. Investment is not influenced by income in this simple model. The equilibrium requires equality of investment and saving. But is this a stable equilibrium? To solve this problem, first think about a point to the right of ISS. Saving would exceed desired investment, and firms want to reduce production. And we move to the left. If we are to the left of the equilibrium, planned saving would be below planned investment, as consumers spend more than anticipated and inventories decline. Now, firms will increase production, so GDP is increasing. And now it is clear that it is a stable equilibrium, because the arrows point towards the equilibrium. The economy will return to equilibrium after a small disturbance. And now we understand what the model is all about, and now it is safe to do some mathematics. I only need three equations and three steps to arrive at the solution of our model for Earth. The first equation is the investment function. Second, the saving function, and third, the equilibrium equation. In order to solve the model, I will substitute equations 1 and 2 into 3. I rearrange to bring all exogenous variables and parameters to the right-hand side. And this expression is called the reduced form equation for GPP. We use the reduced form equation for GPP to analyze what happened at the start of the Great Recession in 2008. In order to use the reduced form equation for GPP, we need data. GPP in 2008 and 2009, investment in 2008 and 2009, and the marginal rate of consumption based on total final consumption. Now, this is the right moment to stop the video and to find the data. I am confident that you already know where to look. I will discuss this further in the data exercise video.